Hello everyone, my name is Rajiv Kohli and welcome back to our channel The Teacher. And in this tutorial I will teach you how to make single line notebook in Microsoft Excel. In my last video I had shown that how you can do the same thing in Microsoft Word using tables. So we will do the same in Microsoft Excel. We will create the same single line notebook design in Microsoft Excel, and by the way, that is more easier than Microsoft Word. It takes less time than Microsoft Word to design the single line notebook in Microsoft Excel. So let's get started, and I will open a new workbook by clicking on the file menu, new, and then choose blank workbook. And I will place this one on my second monitor. A few years back, I had also published a video about the page setup in Microsoft Excel. That was basically about how you can use margin, orientation and size. And you can go and watch that video also to learn more about page settings. And I am telling you this because we also need to set up the page before we start typing on this worksheet. So always remember that before start working in any worksheet in Microsoft Excel, you must first click on the file menu and then click on the print to see the print preview. So we didn't find anything to print as our worksheet is empty. But why I click on this print preview button? Because after that, when you come back to your worksheet, you start seeing this dotted line here. So this dotted line indicates that the width of your page on the worksheet is up to this point. And if you scroll down, then it will also show you a horizontal dotted line, and that indicates that in the height the page end at this point. So you can see that how after seeing the preview, Microsoft Excel divided your worksheet into separate pages. So our first page is this one, starting from A1 up to I1, and if we look into the height, then we end up at I47 according to the height. After seeing these dotted lines, the next thing you need to do is to set up the required number of columns on the worksheet. As we only need two columns in this design, so first I will take this A column. I will hold down right from here and will increase the size, the width of the column. Let's say 18 points. And the next column B, I will move it to the right up to the end of the page. So here it ends. We also need to set the margins, because let's say if I type something here, test, and here I type some numbers and I move down and write something here and a few numbers here. So if now I see the print preview, then you can see a blank margin on the top, on the left, on the right, and at the bottom. You can see that we have blank space on all the four sides of the worksheet, on all the four sides of the page. So we need to start working from the edge of the page. So we can go to the page layout tab and then click on margins. So these are the current margins, normal. So we can go to the custom margin, and here I will set them to 0 from all the four sides. Hit the OK key. And you can see that now this horizontal bottom line moved up to 54 row. Before that it was up to 47th row. And you can also see that the width of the page has increased, because before that our page was ending at this point according to the width. Now we can also increase the size of this B column up to this point. And now we can also move this text to the last row by dragging and dropping. So if now I see the preview, now I am using the full 100% of the page. I can also increase this B column a little bit more. I will continue to increase the size unless it moves to the second page. Now it moved to the second page. So I will decrease the size a little bit. So let me delete this text and we will start designing our notebook. So we first need to increase the height of the first row, and you can do this by two ways. You can either hold on from this point and start dropping down to increase the height of the row, or you can also right click on this row number and choose row height, and here you can specify a particular height in points, like I said 60 points, a little bit more. So I again go to row height and here I type, let's say 90. Now I will also increase the height of the bottom rows. Let's say I select 25 rows, and here you can see that, and here you can see at the bottom left corner of the selection that how many rows currently I have selected. So I have selected 25 rows, and now I will right click on these numbers, row height, and here I choose, let's say 35. Yes, 35 is fine, or you can also decrease this a little bit, let's say 30. So here at the bottom you can see that one row is moving to the next page vertically. So we will use up to this point. So next thing is applying the borders. So first I will select this column up to this point where the page ends vertically. And now I will right click, choose format cell, and here I will move to borders. So here I need to define a custom border. And for that, first I will choose the color red, and then I will choose the style double line. Now I will click on this point because according to my selection, I need a red double border on the right side of the selected column. So here I will click on this point in the preview section and hit the OK key. So here we have the right red border, double line border up to the last cell of the page. Now I will select this row and again will move to the format cell and will click on borders, will choose double style red color, and this time I need to apply the border at the bottom. So that represents the bottom point of the selected cells. So here I will click on that point, hit the OK key. And here we also have a double line. You must remember that the default grid lines of Microsoft Excel worksheet are not printed by default. So if you see the preview, let's see the preview. Here you can see that those lines are not visible in the preview. And if you want to see them in the print preview, then you can go to the page layout and here you can make a check mark on print. So if now I see the print preview, you can see that the default grid lines are now visible in the preview and they will also get printed. If you turn off this button, then it will zoom out the preview. And here you can see that the default line, if you print the default lines of Microsoft Excel, then these lines are the dotted lines. If you need solid black lines, then you have to apply the borders by yourself. So I will uncheck this option. And now I will select all these cells up to this point. Now I will right click and will choose format cell and will move to borders tab. And here I will choose this border, the thin border and black color. So where I want to apply the border? On these lines. So I will choose that point and this one. So according to my selection, all the lines will get converted into black solid line. Hit the OK key, and now if you see the preview, then there you have the notebook design. So lastly, you need to go to the insert tab, click on the shapes drop down menu, and here you can choose rounded corner rectangle, or you can also choose any other shape if you want to, and I will draw that shape right here. And now I will choose no fill from the shape format tab and will change the outline of the rounded corner rectangle to black, and will also increase the weight a little bit and we'll change the outline color to red. Okay, now I want to write the text in this text box. So I will right click on this border and will choose edit text, and now I can type the text. You also need to change the text color, and you can do that by pressing Ctrl A and then choose text fill black. And then page number. And if you need an extra space between them, then hit an extra enter. Now I will adjust the size. That's fine. So now we need to type the text here, and let's say I type here. So you can use the home tab to apply a little bit formatting to this text. So I want to align this to center, bold, size a little bit bigger, and red color. And here goes our first question. What did the wind do to get the man's coat off? And here we have the answer. And finally, you might also need to adjust the vertical alignment of this text, and you can do that by then you can select the text and adjust the horizontal alignment from these three buttons: left alignment, center alignment, and right alignment. But what if you want to align the text vertically? And for that, you can select the text, right click, format cell, go to the format cells, and here move to the alignment tab, and here you can find that vertical alignment option. Here you can find both of the option, horizontal and vertical alignment. The horizontal alignment buttons are right here, and if you look on top, then you can also find the vertical alignment buttons. So these six buttons defines that where you want to put the text in the particular cell. So let's say if I want to put that text to the bottom right, then I can choose this one. So right now I need them at bottom left, so first I will choose bottom and then I will choose left, and I also want them to move a little bit forward from the left. So that is not the right way. If you double click here to edit the text in the cell, and if you start pressing the space key, then that is not the right way. Just like Microsoft Word, like in Microsoft Word, you can select the text and can easily move them by using the indents. There you have left indent, right indent, first line indent. So you can adjust the left indent to move the text forward or backward. The same thing can also be done in Microsoft Excel. You just need to select the text, and there you have these two buttons, increase indent and decrease indent. But unfortunately, in Microsoft Excel, you only have the left indent options. So you can move the text a little bit forward from the left alignment. And if the alignment is set to right, then if you use the increase or decrease indent, then it will start increasing or decreasing the indent from the right side. So it totally depends on the text alignment. If the alignment is set to left and if you then use the indent, then it will start increasing the indent from the left side. And if the alignment is set to right, and now if you use increase indent, then it will start moving from the right side. So that way you can adjust the indents. So here we have the final design. So I hope you will like it. Let me know by liking, sharing, and commenting on this video. And you can also subscribe to our channel for more upcoming tutorial videos.